How to make resource packs, also known as texture packs, for Minecraft Bedrock Edition on Windows in under 5 minutes. To start off, let's download the default resource pack using this link, which you can find in the description of this video. Now unzip the file. I'm putting it on my desktop to make things easier. Now let's create a new folder for the custom resource pack. We also need to give our pack a name and description, which are stored in the manifest.json file. Let's go ahead and copy that file from the vanilla folder and paste it into our packs folder. Now open the file. You can use any text editor, but I recommend using Notepad++ or VS Code, which will be linked in the description. But for the sake of this video, I will use Notepad. Okay, so before you panic, don't worry, this is actually really simple. As you can see, there is a name for the pack here, as well as a description. I'm changing the name in description, but it's not done. You also need to change the UUIDs. A UUID is a conventionally unique identifier, and in this case, it allows Minecraft to differentiate each pack. So to generate one, go to this website. We need two UUIDs for a manifest, so select two in the version 4 generator. Now let's paste the first UUID. And now the second one. Finally, the min engine version is for the minimum supported version. I suggest keeping it the same as the latest vanilla resource pack manifest. The manifest is done, but the resource pack also has an icon. Let's paste the vanilla's icon into our custom pack. I will be using paint.net here. You can use any resolution you want. Now that we have everything set up, it's time to change some textures. For example, let's change the oak planks textures. To do that, create a folder named textures and inside it another one called blocks. Locate the oak planks in the vanilla resource pack and paste the textures in the blocks folder. Let's open the file and make the textures nicer. If you don't have an image editing software, I recommend using paint.net, GIMP, or Krita, which are all free. There you go, the textures are done. It's time to import the pack into Minecraft. All you need to do is select the pack folder and convert it into a zip file. Now right-click it and rename the zip extension at the end of the file's name to mcpack. Press OK. And the file's icon should turn into the Minecraft logo. Just double-click the file, Minecraft will open, and the pack will get imported. Now, let's test if it works. Don't forget to apply the pack. As you can see, the oak planks now have a new look. If you'd like to update your resource pack, there is a very efficient way to do it. But first, let's delete it from the Minecraft storage. Now, to access the com.mojang folder, which is where all your worlds and addons are stored, be sure to have hidden items enabled in the file explorer. Then, press Windows key and R, and the window should pop up. Type %localappdata%. Now press enter and go to Packages, Microsoft.minecraft.uwp, and a bunch of random numbers, local state, games, com.mojang, and finally, development resource packs. This folder is where you can store all the resource packs you're working on. So copy the custom pack folder and paste it here. Now, whenever you make changes to it, Minecraft will automatically update the resource pack without having to restart it. However, you still need to leave and rejoin the world you were in. To test this, I'm gonna change the zombie's texture. Thank you. As you can see, its textures got updated. Thanks for watching and please subscribe.